Imagine a hurricane is approaching to the coastline, where there are a few cities. The forecast says it will landfall in 2 days following this path, but the truth is that this path is only the average of all the simulation runs they have, so they have to give us a window of uncertainty. That basically means that the hurricane actually could end up at any place of this coastline. So the question here is this information enough to take any decision about what to do with these people in these cities? I don't think so. That's why in my thesis we attain a better quantification of uncertainty, providing more information about what is going to happen. But in fact, this is not easy. We had to sort out a few problems first. The first problem was related to dimensionality. Geophysical models, like this one, have thousands or even millions of state variables that we need to estimate. And in general, high-dimensional problems are not easy to deal with. The second main problem I see is related to the model itself, the complexity of the model. Models like this one have many parameters that need to be adjusted before doing any forecast, just to assure the model will behave as it should. But we have already proposed an algorithm that can manage these both problems. It's a general and recursive method that performs inference at two levels, one nested inside the other. In the first layer, this one, we have a grid-based scheme that approximates the posterior probability distribution of the parameters. And in the second layer, we have filtering techniques that track different conditional probability distributions of the state variables. This can be seen as a divide and conquer approach that turns out to be much more efficient than conventional methods that tackle all the unknowns, parameters, and states at the same level. And we have seen also that we can not only narrow this window of uncertainty, but we can also provide more information about how this uncertainty is distributed, and then reduce risks in situations like this one. Thank you for watching.